bu prensipleri yoktan indiği sanılan kitapların doğmalarıyla asla bir tutmamalıdır. Biz ilhamlarımızı yoktan ve dahipten değil, doğrudan doğruya hayattan almış bulunuyoruz.
Hi everyone and welcome, this is the Apostate Prophet. Today I want to talk about the Turk who destroyed Islam. I'm not talking about myself, that would be very arrogant. I'm talking about Ataturk, a national hero to Turks. Few weeks ago I talked about what a caliphate is, and the history of the Islamic caliphate. And today I want to talk about the one man who destroyed the unity of Muslims and Islam forever. Oh, before I start, like almost all of my videos, this video will probably be demonetized, which means I cannot support these videos through any monetization. In order to continue what I'm doing, it is very important to have your support. You can support my work on Patreon or on ApostateProfit.com through donations. If you find my work important, please help me go on and create even more. Thank you so much. Okay, let's keep going. Some of you might know that I'm of Turkish origin, others might not even care. I don't blame you, I don't care either. For Turkish people, it is impossible not to know about Ataturk. Ataturk is the most important historical figure to most Turks. He's respected, loved, truly venerated. Statues of him are everywhere in Turkey. You see him when you go to school. You have dedicated holidays for him. In fact, on November 10th every year, at the time of the day he died, Turkey stands in silence for 1 minute in his honor. Personally, I've never been able to really relate to that, because I grew up in a religious family that didn't really care for the secular Ataturk. And probably also because I grew up in Germany, really adopting a German Western mindset. And in Germany, I learned not to idolize and deify a figure, because, obviously. No, not just because of that, but with a German mindset, you just don't do that, right? I understand why Turks idolize Ataturk so much, though. Ataturk literally saved Turkey. He saved it from being subdued and partitioned. The Ottoman Empire was allied to Germany and was part of the losing side in World War I. The Ottoman Empire, where the ruler was also the Caliph, the spiritual ruler over the Muslim world, accepted defeat in World War I and sat down with the Allies for negotiations. The Allies proposed that Ottoman Turkey should be hit very heavily. It would be financially limited, nearly entirely disarmed, internationally tried for war crimes, territories given to Greece, Armenia, and a possible Kurdistan, Istanbul taken and internationalized, and more. This was a very heavy payback for the aggressive history of the Ottoman Empire, the alliance with the German Empire, and war crimes and genocides that were said to have taken place. The Ottoman rulers, under occupation, signed the treaties of their defeat, but Mustafa Kemal Ataturk, who was a very successful and influential commander in the Ottoman army, started a new movement against this defeat of the Ottoman Empire and the loss of independence. He resigned from the Ottoman army, awakened the defeated Turkish people, and established, together with them and many other figures of the war, a national movement and a new parliament that became known as the Grand National Assembly. Ataturk led Turkey through what is known as the Turkish War of Independence. Turkey's claimed land, what remained from the Ottoman Empire, was occupied by Greece, France, the UK, and Armenia. The Turkish nationalists decisively won this war, expelled the occupying forces, drove out the Ottoman government, and went on to form a new nation. Turks are today very proud of this, and they credit their bravery and their willpower, and mostly the leadership of Ataturk. In more religious circles, Islam is praised and credited, which is ironic because the Ottoman Empire was on the losing side and the Ottoman Empire was the leader of Islam. But whatever. After the victory, under Ataturk, a new nation was to be formed, and a lot of changes began, known as Ataturk's reforms or revolutions. This revolution in Turkish state, society, economy, education, religion, and more forms the basis of today's secular Turkish Republic. With Ataturk's reforms, the Ottoman Sultanate was abolished, the Ottoman dynasty was expelled, which ended more than 600 years of monarchy. Westernization was adopted, secularism was installed, the caliphate system was abolished, Turkey replaced the Arabic alphabet with the Latin alphabet, the Quran and other Islamic texts were translated into Turkish, the Islamic call to prayer was translated into Turkish. Numerous Islamic institutes, especially Sufi orders where Sufi saints were venerated, were closed down and banned. Gender equality was almost completely guaranteed and women went into politics. Turkey became a very different country. Ataturk believed that it was the foremost goal of Turkey to keep up with modern civilization and even become more modern than the West. Now, of course, Ataturk was not perfect. Some of the things that he implemented were done forcefully. They took lives. And the absolute veneration of one individual, no matter how good he was, is simply regressive in the long run. But I don't want to make this about praising Ataturk and telling about the great things that he did anyway. I just want to appreciate a specific thing that he did, and I want to think a little bit about it. Abolishing the caliphate. As explained in an earlier video, Islam is supposed to be a world power, not just a religion where people believe in God and live a good life in order to go to wherever they need to go. A caliph, a leader of the religion, the state, and the armies of the global Muslim community, is a requirement in Islam. And Muslims everywhere around the world are required to follow this caliph, not only as a religious authority, but also in order to expand Islam to the world. Militarily, primarily. That's how it happened since Muhammad, who started this tradition, by not only being the head of Islam, but also the head of the state and the commander of the Muslim armies. The commander of the faithful, that's what the caliph is called. Islam is not only a religion, it is a state, a military force, a world power. Ataturk, who repeatedly called out the corruption of the Ottoman Empire and the backwardness and aggressiveness of the Islamic Authority, considered this an obstacle to human civilization and just abolished it. Instead of continuing the caliphate and using it for his purposes, this enormous power, he just got rid of it. And now Muslim nations are divided everywhere without leadership. Now there is no proper authority on Islam anymore, and people just live and interpret Islam the way they want to. Or they just get rid of it. When Islamist groups in our time and Islamist individuals speak of establishing a new caliphate and uniting the divided Muslim ummah, the Muslim community, this is what they are referring to. Among many religious Islamic circles, Ataturk is hated and accused of being an agent of the West or the enemies of Islam, because he did not only secularize Turkey, his own nation, he also destroyed the unity and the religious leadership of Muslims and Islam in the world. As Ataturk built his new ideal, secular nation, he also began the destruction of the enemy of his nation, of all nations, of humankind, Islam. Think about it, the caliphate was the throne of Islam, the head of Islam, the leadership of Islamic power, and now it's gone. The West defeated it, Ataturk abolished it, and the Muslim world turned away from it. 1,300 years of bloody conquest, powerful authoritarianism, united religiously motivated backwardness, and extreme fanaticism stopped existing. We have Muslim nations today, many of them heavily built on secular ideas, that do not intend to follow a caliphate again, because freedom, peace, and progress feel much better than the corrupt and barbaric system that they had before. More Muslims are realizing that, which is why fundamentalist, revivalist groups fail to find any support to re-establish their caliphate. Not only non-Muslims, Muslims themselves don't want this anymore, which shows that Islam has failed. Islam was supposed to be united by this major force, and now it's gone, and it will never be able to come back again. Ataturk destroyed Islam after the West defeated Islam. Now Muslims are changing Islam, and eventually it is time for Muslims to give up Islam and to move on to a brighter future. Oh, but before that, it is first our turn and my turn to help Islam die. Because as Islam dies, humanity becomes more alive, and we all want to live happier and better without Islam. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to like, to subscribe, and to share. If you want to support me and everything that I'm doing, you can support me on Patreon or on apostateprophet.com. Thank you all so much for your support. I will be back again. Until then, have a fantastic day and stay away from Islam.